NetSim can be used for network planning and design. For illustration, we have a simple enterprise network comprising of two branches, headquarters and a data center. Branches and the headquarters are connected to the data center over the public cloud. As you can see, we have modeled the network in NetSim by just adding the network elements through click and drop and renaming them suitably. Once the devices have been connected, the only configuration that needs to be done is to set the IP addresses and set up different parameters on the devices and links. In our network scenario, we will set the link rate for the outbound link that is link 28 from branch 1 as 2 Mbps, and then configure applications at branch 1. The application we have created has one FTP flow, from system 1 to the file server, a database flow from system 2 to the database server, and 8 email applications running between the other branch systems and the email server. Now we will simulate this network. Once the simulation is complete, NetSim generates a set of performance reports. First, let us click on the View Packet Animation, and this opens out the Animator module, where you can see the flow of packets in the network. As you would see, it shows how the network would perform on startup, with initial OSPF packets being exchanged to set up the root tables. Then before the application flow starts, the three-way TCP handshake is done, and then you can see the flow of different application packets. Next, coming to the reports, let us focus on the delays experienced by the email applications. As we can see, they have an average delay of about 3.36 million microseconds, or in other words 3.36 seconds. Let's do something interesting. We will add more nodes via a switch in branch 1 and configure 3 of them to run FTP applications. Now let's simulate it. The essence of this experiment is to understand the impact of this additional load on the network. Let's look at the email application metrics. We now see that the average delay has increased to 14.27 seconds. Let us do a bit more experimentation. Now we change the data rate of the outbound link, that is, link 28 to 4 Mbps from 2 Mbps and simulate. From the application report, we see that the average delay for the email application has dropped down to 0.54 seconds. Let us go back and set the outbound link rate to 2 Mbps. From the nodes connected to the branch 1, we will run a voice conference call with head office. Let's simulate this. The idea of this change is to observe that voice has a higher priority over data, and the routers will first serve the voice packets in its queue and only then route the data packets. The application metrics shows that the voice calls have been prioritized by the router, and the email application starts experiencing significant delays. In this case, the average delay for the email application has increased to 25.26 seconds. In our last experiment, we start the voice calls and FTP transfers at 40 seconds, while the email application runs from time 30 seconds itself. When we simulate this and see the throughput graphs, we notice that email enjoys a good throughput initially, after which it starts dropping. On the other hand, the voice application throughput is flat till 40 seconds, since it has no traffic, and starts picking up 40 seconds onwards. Note that these are moving average graphs and not instantaneous value plots. We hope this video gave you an idea of how NetSim can be used for impact assessment and for network planning. Thanks for watching.